시키기 위해서는 서로 같은 시각을
보고 Nations with strong allies thrive and those without with them. As Republic of Korea and United States,
any attack on the United States or on our allies will be defeated, and any use of nuclear weapons would be met with a response that would be effective and overwhelming.
provocation by North Korea, a country that has been dogged in its pursuit of a robust weapons program. The White House was made aware of the news. President Trump, however, did not answer questions about it during a brief appearance with Japan's prime minister. On Friday, President Trump pledged to help ensure Japan has a strong defense against North Korea, leading some to wonder whether this latest missile test is a show of force to the new administration.
The administration is facing a dire warning from North Korea in its very first week. The North Koreans are threatening to, quote, pour further misery on the U.S., and a warning coming 49 years after North Korea captured a Navy ship. It's the USS Pueblo. This as South Korea warns that the North is developing nuclear weapons at an unprecedented pace. Gordon Chang is an Asia analyst and author of the book Nuclear Showdown, North Korea Takes on the World, aptly titled, as we point out often, Gordon. So what is notable? We've heard from North Korea on and off over the last several years. Why do you think this particular warning is notable?
Well, this comes at the beginning of the Trump administration. The North Koreans obviously want to test what Trump's intentions are towards Pyongyang. And the other thing that's important about this is that the Chinese are helping the North Koreans. The Chinese have provided nuclear weapons technology, fissile material, all sorts of plans for mobile missile launchers and other things. And so basically we're facing a challenge, not just from Pyongyang, but from Beijing as well.
So in the best possible scenario, when you look at the best possible response from the United States with such a threat or an actual missile test, what would that look like?
Well, first of all, the United States needs to support South Korea, which is going through an impeachment crisis right now. The president, who is a strong U.S. supporter, is under fire. She probably will be removed from office. That jeopardizes plans for missile defense for South Korea. I think the United States needs to warn China, not only privately, but also in public. And we need to start sanctioning Chinese banks because they've been helping North Korea. And we have been shying away from enforcing our own laws. These banks have should be unplugged from the global financial system. That would cause a shock, but at least we would be showing Beijing that we were serious about protecting ourselves from North Korea's missiles and nukes.
I want to go back to something we mentioned in the introduction, and that is the taking of the ship, the USS Pueblo. I think a lot of our viewers probably have forgotten about this. Tell us a little bit about what happened, why it's significant that North Korea is referencing it.
Well, the Pueblo is in international waters. The North Koreans took it. They imprisoned the crew for almost a year. We gave an apology to get it back. One of the crewmen died. Also, not long after that, in April 1969, the North Koreans shot down an Air Force EC-121 reconnaissance plane. 31 crew members died in that incident. That's the largest single loss of American life during the Cold War. The United States did nothing about that. We did nothing about the Pueblo. So the Chinese think that they can, for instance, interfere with U.S. aircraft and ships with impunity. They took the drone last month, and we didn't do anything about that either.
So you're saying it's a ripple effect. Donald Trump in the past has put many things on Twitter, and I'm wondering if you could take a look inside the minds of the North Koreans, if you would, Gordon. I know with your work, obviously your book, you've had time to think about this. If you're a North Korean, you're a North Korean leader, and you see a tweet from Donald Trump that says this, North Korea just stated that it is in the final stages of developing a nuclear weapon capable of reaching parts of the U.S., it won't happen. That's what Donald Trump said. He went on to say in a following tweet that China has been taking out massive amounts of money and wealth from the U.S. in totally one-sided trade, but won't help with North Korea. Nice exclamation point. When you hear that, what do you think North Korea is hearing, and what do you think of that in general?
Yeah, North Korea is hearing a threat, because what they say, you know, Donald Trump says it's not going to happen. And he's not saying, oh, look, they can't do it. The North Koreans are saying, well, look, the United States is going to do something actively to prevent us from launching a missile.
Is that a good thing?
In a sense, if we back it up with actions, yes, it is, because it'll be an act of will and will show not only the North Koreans, but also the Chinese and the Russians behind them that we are willing to defend ourselves. Now, China, when it sees all these tweets from Donald Trump, thinks that there's going to be a new response. They're going to try to challenge him as well because they want to knock him off his game. If they can do that early in his administration, they set the tone for 4 and maybe 8 years.
Wow, so you're really watching the next several hours, next several days, Gordon, from that part of the particular part of the world, North Korea and China.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Because right. this is where it all gets settled.
Thank you.
北朝鮮のミサイル発射は断じて容認できません。
North Korea's most recent missile launch is absolutely intolerable.
北朝鮮は国連決議を完全に遵守すべきです。
North Korea must fully comply with the relevant UN Security Council resolutions.
先ほどトランプ大統領との首脳会談の中において、米国は常に 100% 日本と共にあるということを明言されました。そしてその意思を示すために今私の隣に立っておられます。
During the summit meeting that I had with President Trump, he assured me that the United States will always with Japan 100%. And to demonstrate his determination as well as commitment, he is now here with me at this joint press conference.
私とトランプ大統領は日米同盟をさらに緊密化し、そして強化していくことで完全に一致をいたしました。
President Trump and I myself completely shared a view that we are going to promote further collaboration between the two nations and also we are going to further reinforce our alliance.
私からは以上です。
That is from myself.
。Thank you very much, Mr. Prime Minister.I just want everybody to understand and fully know that the United States of America stands behind Japan, its great ally, 100%. Thank you.
Nations with strong allies thrive and those without wither. As Republic of Korea and United States...
Any attack on the United States or on our allies will be defeated and any use of nuclear weapons would be met with a response that would be effective and overwhelming.
Provocation by North Korea, a country that has been dogged in its pursuit of a robust weapons program. The White House was made aware of the news. President Trump, however, did not answer questions about it during a brief appearance with Japan's prime minister. On Friday, President Trump pledged to help ensure Japan has a strong defense against North Korea, leading some to wonder whether this latest missile test is a show of force to the new administration.
It's facing a dire warning from North Korea in its very first week. The North Koreans are threatening to, quote, pour further misery on the U.S., and a warning coming 49 years after North Korea captured a Navy ship. It's the USS Pueblo. This as South Korea warns that the North is developing nuclear weapons at an unprecedented pace. Gordon Chang is an Asia analyst and author of the book Nuclear Showdown, North Korea Takes on the World, aptly titled, as we point out often, Gordon. So what is notable? We've heard from North Korea on and off over the last several years. Why do you think this particular warning is notable?
Well, this comes at the beginning of the Trump administration. The North Koreans obviously want to test what Trump's intentions are towards Pyongyang. And the other thing that's important about this is that the Chinese are helping the North Koreans. The Chinese have provided nuclear weapons technology, fissile material, all sorts of plans for mobile missile launchers and other things. And so basically we're facing a challenge, not just from Pyongyang, but from Beijing as well.
So in the best possible scenario, when you look at the best possible response from the United States with such a threat or an actual missile test, what would that look like?
Well, first of all, the United States needs to support South Korea, which is going through an impeachment crisis right now. The president, who is a strong U.S. supporter, is under fire. She probably will be removed from office. That jeopardizes plans for missile defense for South Korea. I think the United States needs to warn China, not only privately, but also in public. And we need to start sanctioning Chinese banks because they've been helping North Korea. And we have been shying away from enforcing our own laws. These banks have be unplugged from the global financial system. That would cause a shock, but at least we would be showing Beijing that we were serious about protecting ourselves from North Korea's missiles and nukes.
I want to go back to something we mentioned in the introduction, and that is the taking of the ship, the USS Pueblo. I think a lot of our viewers probably have forgotten about this. Tell us a little bit about what happened, why it's significant that North Korea is referencing it.
Well, the Pueblo was in international waters. The North Koreans took it. They imprisoned the crew for almost a year. We gave an apology to get it back. One of the crewmen died. Also, not long after that, in April 1969, the North Koreans shot down an Air Force EC-121 reconnaissance plane. 31 crew members died in that incident. That's the largest single loss of American life during the Cold War. The United States did nothing about that. We did nothing about the Pueblo. So the Chinese think that they can, for instance, interfere with U.S. aircraft and ships with impunity. They took the drone last month, and we didn't do anything about that either.
So you're saying it's a ripple effect. Donald Trump in the past has put many things on Twitter, and I'm wondering if you could take a look inside the minds of the North Koreans, if you would, Gordon. I know with your work, obviously your book, you've had time to think about this. If you're a North Korean, you're a North Korean leader, and you see a tweet from Donald Trump that says this: North Korea just stated that it is in the final stages of developing a nuclear weapon capable of reaching parts of the U.S., it won't happen. That's what Donald Trump said. He went on to say in a following tweet that China has been taking out massive amounts of money and wealth from the U.S. in totally one-sided trade, but won't help with North Korea. Nice! Exclamation point. When you hear that, what do you think North Korea is hearing, and what do you think of that in general?
Yeah, North Korea is hearing a threat, because what they say, you know, Donald Trump says it's not going to happen. And he's not saying, oh, look, they can't do it. The North Koreans are saying, well, look, the United States is going to do something actively to prevent us from launching a missile.
Is that a good thing?
In a sense, if we back it up with actions, yes, it is, because it'll be an act of will and we'll show not only the North Koreans, but also the Chinese and the Russians behind them that we are willing to defend ourselves. Now, China, when it sees all these tweets from Donald Trump, thinks that there's going to be a new response. They're going to try to challenge him as well because they want to knock him off his game. If they can do that early in his administration, they set the tone for 4 and maybe 8 years.
Wow, so you're really watching the next several hours, next several days, Gordon, from that part of the particular part of the world, North Korea and China.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Because right. This is, you know, this is where it all gets settled.
Thank you.
北朝鮮のミサイル発射は断じて容認できません.
North Korea's most recent missile launch is absolutely intolerable.
北朝鮮は国連決議を完全に遵守すべきです.
North Korea must fully comply with the relevant UN Security Council resolutions.
先ほどトランプ大統領との首脳会談の中において米国は常に 100% 日本と共にあるということを明言されました。そしてその意思を示すために今私の隣に立っておられます。
During the summit meeting that I had with President Trump, he assured me that the United States will always with Japan 100%. And to demonstrate his determination as well as commitment, he is now here with me at this joint press conference.
私とトランプ大統領は日米同盟をさらに緊密化し、そして強化していくことで 完全に 一致をいたしました。
President Trump and I myself completely shared a view that we are going to promote further collaboration between the two nations and also we are going to further reinforce our alliance.
私からは以上です。
That is from myself.
谢谢您，Mr.Prime Minister。 I just want everybody to understand and fully know that the United States of America stands behind Japan, its great ally, 100%.